All right, and welcome everybody here in Twitch chat and also on YouTube if you're watching this video later. For our next deck, which is we have another donation deck here, another tribal deck, just like we had just vampires a little bit ago. Now we have goblins. So this is a donation deck that somebody used with their by signing up for Quip. So they signed up for Quip. Awesome electric toothbrush. Again, don't forget to use my referral code. And if you're watching this on YouTube, you can find the referral code down at the bottom in the description. If you sign up for Quip with my code, you get a free donation deck. And so the person said, hey, I'd like you to make a goblin deck. And so here we are. Just kind of like the vampire deck, I'm trying to be very linear with our deck here. And we have Volley Veteran, or we have Trash Masters in here. They're right there. Not trying to fool around with like a lot of removal. I'm not like kind of jamming the deck up with like some shocks and some lightning strikes and things like that. I'm just kind of playing my creatures and attacking and trying to make cards like Goblin War Chief, Goblin Trash Master, and Volley Veteran as good as they can be, because we are just playing, you know, all goblins. Siege Gang Commander, you know, is a little bit on the top end. You know, costs 5 mana. At first, I had one copy of Siege Gang Commander in here and decided to replace it with an Experimental Frenzy. So we'll kind of see there. But I originally had that. I was kind of talking about this with the vampire deck a little bit ago. The problem with putting too many like higher mana cost cards in your deck like this is that we're not playing card draw. So it's hard to like hit like our 5 land drops in succession while we're also like, you know, and also have like other spells. If we're like trying to hit our 5th land drop, we have to like play more lands, which means we have less spells. So like we'll have like a less powerful draws and things like that. Yeah, so that's what we have going on. So I decided to play the Frenzy over the Siege Gang Commander. We'll kind of see how that goes there. So we have more so in our sideboard we have more Frenzies also for removal heavy decks. We get to go real Frenzy heavy. Lava Coils if we do need the removal against whatever we're playing. Daredevil, because that card's kind of cool. Even though it's not a goblin, just a good card. And then we have like the Cinder Vines and Collision Colossus. So Collision can be our answers to like Lyra, Dawnbringer, which is a card I'm worried about. Cinder Vines can come on in against like the Wilderness Reclamation decks and so on. Yeah, you can get Quip in Canada. They ship worldwide. Free shipping worldwide is what it said on the little promotional thing that I had. So yeah, let's try it out. We'll see if we can get more wins with goblins than we did with vampires. We got 2-2 with vampires, which is not bad, because you know to make it to 2-2, you have to be 2-1, because this isn't like a 4-round FNM where you can be 0-2 and then win your last two rounds and go 2-2. Once you pick up your second loss, you're done. So you know, to get to 2-2, you have to be 2-1. And then lose your last one. So, 2-2 is not so bad. Respectable. Oh, I did not update our decklist command, I don't think. Here in Twitch chat, so let's go ahead and do that. Nothing on turn 2, but I don't have a lot of 2 drops. There's not a lot of great 2 mana gobos. We can just kind of fit this Stomping Ground in tapped in that spot right there. Anything that doesn't go 5-0 is bad. Thanks, Ingle of Jax. Yeah, it's an awesome toothbrush. It's like I said, I haven't like ever like spent a lot of money on a toothbrush or anything. I've usually had like the electric toothbrushes that are like around $10 at like the grocery store kind of thing. This one is a whole lot better. And I think I am enjoying it too more because I'm just, you know, learned like the correct serving of toothpaste, and I think that helps out too. Quip. Donation decks are usually $20. They have a $25 toothbrush that's plastic and a $40 toothbrush that's metal. You can get either one, but so just even for $5 more than a donation deck, you get your donation deck, plus you get the toothbrush sent to you, plus you get a free refill sent to you in 3 months as well with the toothpaste and head. So real great deal if you're looking to wanting me to play a deck on stream anyway. The 13 land best of one red deck, that's got to be a... Yeah, oh, it's right there. It says best of one. I was going to say that's got to be a best of one deck because you can't possibly do the 13 lands in best 2 out of 3. You can only do 13 lands with that algorithm. Besides that, that's what you just said about the deck is all I know about the deck, that it's a 13 land deck. I don't play best of one myself, so I don't know anything else about the deck. Alright, no counter but a fog. I'm glad we have four Cindervines chilling in our sideboard. I'm hoping we find our Cindervines that we got in our sideboard. Oh, I should play my card. Doesn't matter too much. I mean, we're, you know, like, attacking them for a bunch, but they could have, like, a Krasis that, like, maybe the Volley Veteran kills. Like, that's something they could be playing here. But Volley Veteran would probably, just having that attacker. But maybe they think they would stay alive from the Krasis. Today, you found out that Firebrand was a goblin and not a monkey. Does kind of seem like a monkey. Does the opponent have a one mana card here? Love the art of the veteran. Look at the direction of the arrows. Yeah, that is pretty cool how, like, the arrows are just going everywhere. That is pretty cool. Why is there a cucumber? There's just a random cucumber here? What if, like, that cucumber that's on the right of this art, what if that's, like, only on, how crazy would that be if that's, like, only on Arena and they just have it, like, there to see if anybody notices, but, like, if you get, like, an actual, like, Volley Veteran card, it doesn't actually have that. That'd be kind of crazy. I think I'm going to take out the veterans here, though, for the Cindervines and call it a day. Okay, it's there. But, like, how, like, that'd be pretty funny if they just did that with something and, like, see if anybody notices. I guess we just got a bunch of 1/1s. We'll see if 1/1s win. Hey, it's up, DJ Poly B. If we play the Firebrand first, we hit him to 19, and the next turn we hit him to 18. By playing the Banneret, we hit him, next turn we hit him down to 18. It's the same either way. I guess it's better to Better play these two things, I suppose. Hmm. Doesn't really matter. It's the same. Get Warchief out right away. Oh, 10th Street has haste? Oh. Learn something new every day. Alright, I missed a point of damage. Missed a point. Ooh. Boom! Opponent couldn't handle the Cinder Vines. Couldn't handle the Cinder Vines. Alright, we found out how if you're tired of Nexus, you need to beat Nexus. You got it, Sir Swindler. Goblins. Coming through clutch, 1-0. Sir Swindler did. Signed up for Quip. Sir Swindler signed up for Quip, so said I want to see some goblins. So here we go, we got some goblins. Goblins, 100% win rate versus Nexus. Dude, I hope we face Nexus 5 times, and I hope we beat it 5 times. Alright. A new start. Sounds like a Nexus player. Oh, I'm on the play. I thought I was on the draw. Whoops. Ooh, Nexus player. Dang it. Instigator or Dweller? I guess Dweller is better against Trickster. Hey, Sir Swindler is getting that gifted sub. Thanks, DJ Polly B, gifting out your 32nd sub. That is so many. Santa, DJ Polly B, gifting out the sub. Santa in March. Nice, Methvillain. There's no L there. Methvillain. Anyway, I'm glad you're enjoying the Grixis discard deck from earlier. Alright, I'm kind of feeling a trickster here. I don't think I want to throw this 10th Street Dodger out there. I'm feeling my opponent trickstering. I wanted to play these first, though, to kind of, you know, see, like, if our opponent countered the Instigator, we know the Dodger comes in and all that kind of stuff. Well, I can sack the goblins later when I have mana. I don't have the mana yet. Wait. Yeah, it's this turn. We get to resolve Trashmaster. The lady that owned the truck before me had bought a rainbow unicorn head to wear. That's hilarious. Ooh. Let's go to combat. They have more tricksters. Seems like they have another Trickster. It was the dive down. Called that one. Oh, well, we'll turn our one mana card into another one mana card. That thing is crazy. They just didn't even put a counter on any of the things? They were like, nah, I don't actually want to put a counter on anything. I can respect that. I can respect that. If you're playing 1/1s, you know, you're playing 1/1s and 2/2s, you don't want to make it bigger. There's a reason. Hey, Hawkeye. You want to come see some goblins? Yeah, goblins are fun. Hey, Hawkeye. Yeah, this, like, they must have just hit no instead of yes or something. Instead of the take action, they must have hit, like, the cancel. Maybe they were thinking of, like, maybe they, like, targeted the first one, and they're like, oh, wait, no, I want to target this other thing, and then, like, they were like, no, because they wanted to target something else. I don't know. I should probably play these Lava Coils. And maybe I cut this Frenzy that probably gets countered. Or do I cut Volley Veteran? I don't really know what to take out. Probably need to take out my 4-mana spells. Alright, 2 volley. One of those and... take out another Warchief. This is just kind of a 3-mana 2/2 haste. Alright, goblins, come on. You can do it, little buddies. I guess we could play Collision. It's just more removal, though. I guess maybe we're supposed to have all that removal. I don't know. What do y'all think? Do y'all think I should be playing Collision? Y'all are saying yes. I don't have big fatties. Oh, it takes out big fatties. Okay, gotcha. That's the thing. It's... I don't know. I guess it's... Yeah, I mean, I guess it's better than Lava Coil. Yeah, I'm pretty concerned at actually doing anything. Pretty concerned about that. Man, I want to play a Chain Whirler so bad. Nice. Not even blocking the 10th Street Dodger. I think I should sideboard out a land. I think I can, like, we were trimming our curve. I think I could probably sideboard out a land in this matchup. And that could be one spot for a collision. No Tempest Gin is good. Giving them a little test. Go, War Boss, go. I don't know, I guess the Banneret's kind of scary. It pumps up and gives something else Mentor. Like, we'll be able to make it a 5-1 and Mentor the Goblin Chain Whirler and make the Chain Whirler a 4-4. It's kind of a scary card. Oh, that's awesome. Rex, is he playing it or playing against it? No, not Jin. Ah, this was going so much better when you didn't have Tempest Jin. Opponent. Yeah, I have 23 lands in the deck. Alright, Trash Master, Trash Master, Trash Master. Come on, Trash Master. Trash Master! Oh, that's so close. Why aren't you a Trash Master? Okay, cool. Like, my list of Esper Legends there? Okay, different deck. Gotcha. Different version. All right, opponent went down to 2. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. All they need is a land to kill me. Please don't have a land. They need a land to be able to adapt because they only have 7 towards adapting this Terramander. That's not a land. That's not a land. And Gobos with the win. 2-0. GG, Hawkeye. Yeah, good game. Good game, Hawkeye. Trying to get my GG emotes in there. There we go. Alright, goblins, looking strong. We beat Nexus and Mono Blue. Those are the kind of decks we want to be playing. We don't want to be playing Sultai. We want to play Nexus, though. Come on, Nexus. I want to beat up on these Nexus players. Alright, doesn't look like Nexus. Espa. Alright, so I miss out on getting a 1-1 there, but our war boss doesn't die to that cast down. And we can make sure the war boss resolves underneath an absorb or something like that. Okay, well. We tried. Alright, hope they do not have Kaya's Wrath. Please don't. Kaya's Wrath. Turn 2 removal, turn 3 removal, turn 4 sweeper. That is really tough. Play this card this turn. They can't have another sweeper, right? Man, a moment of craving? Why can't you just have like a bunch of counter spells? Well, not now, but why couldn't they before? They had like just a great anti-aggro hand. This is the best possible moment of craving and absorb left. Yeah, now they have to ferry? Sure, why not? Just only the best possibles.
Right on, skate. Hold that thought.
Just Kaya's Wrath is the best possible moment and absorb that turn. Then to ferry. And they had the other removal spell to kill my war boss. Oh, right, yeah, you untap lands and you still have another removal spell. Yeah, why not? Why not? Okay, well, let's bring in these Cindervines and Frenzies and take out the Volley Veterans. I mean, they're probably going to be bringing in Liras. Do I want Collisions to try to deal with Liras? Chain Whirler is honestly not that great in this matchup. Yeah, they run Lyra in the sideboard. Maybe I don't play Trashmaster. No, we can play Trashmaster. Let's try this. Maybe we can lock our opponent out with these Cinder Vines. That'd be cool. Play first. Mulligan first. I'll take it. We are relying on Frenzy. I think we keep the fourth land in, on top. If we put this on the bottom, we need one of the next three cards to be a land for Frenzy. I guess if one of the next three cards is not a land, we're probably doing okay anyway. So let's put it on the bottom. I think that, you know, the way we lose is like, a, you know, getting a whole bunch of lands and stuff. If that was like a green source, I think I would have been more inclined to keep it. To like make sure we had a green source. Esper does have Mortify. So yeah, Esper has Mortify to be able to destroy Frenzy. So it's not, you know, like they have an answer to it. But it's the kind of card we need. Aha. They already used their Mortify, though. Well, I'm just getting in play underneath the counterspell. Or they just have multiple Mortifies. That is true. They always have the answer. Check out game one. So now they have Kaya's Wrath or whatever. Temp's a pretty good one. Don't have the mana to sacrifice. And keeping the mana up for cards like that, cards like Moment of Craving. Submit. Sacrifice that creature. Don't gain life. They last longer than others. Could just sack one of these 1/1s. Oh yeah, Ryla Kylie's great. Card. That's a card. Stop. Ugh. Well, it's not making it easy. Deck's not really making it easy either. Frenzy. Man, this has been a pretty rough match for us. Just please be a land now. Good. Because we can't play that, you know, we wouldn't be able to play that card anyway, so I didn't want it to be like a Frenzy right there. We're playing goblins, Ewan. No, there's no siege gangs in here. Kind of want to just block, honestly. Nope, no siege tanks either. Just keeping the life total high. Like, yeah, we got the Cinder Vines here. And kill him in four spells. Yeah, Golgari Graveyard's good. Yeah, it's a good deck. Please do not have Absorb. Oh, we've seen 11 lands. Yeah, we've gotten 11 lands. Our Dweller earlier was also hitting lands. More than 9. Whenever we're exiling cards trying to play stuff, we're getting more lands. That's our 12th land and 23 cards. No, we don't have a Banefire. This match has been just brutal, of like opponent always having like such good cards and us just drawing all these lands. Brutal match. Alright, goblins took a loss. Unexpected. We thought we were 5-0 in. But guess not. Yeah, that one was a tilt. Five lands? I mean, Trashmaster is awesome. I mean, if we have something to fill the curve out on turn three. See, this is what I get for mulliganing. We had a similar hand to that with vampires, and I keep, and, you know, we just flood out. Hey, we got the same hand. Some damage next turn. Yeah, it's like the same hand except for just like ripping up two of the lands. Or I guess shuffling two of the lands back into the deck. I can't get through that thing. Thank you. Oh, yeah, you're right. I could have played both. If I play the War Chief first, you're right. Doesn't make a big difference. I'm not... not attacking. Man, what's the deal with running into opponents that just curve out perfectly? What's the deal with that? Yeah, if you want to do a donation deck, donations are through PayPal, yeah. Or, of course, signing up for Quip through my referral link is another option for a donation deck. Get yourself a nice electric toothbrush as well. Attack. We're still fighting. Maybe we can get like some war bosses or something.
Let's meet my newest friend.
Maybe they'll attack with a Ravager Worm. No, that's just for MTGO. That's just for just for Magic Arena. Or sorry, that's just for MTGO if you would buy the deck off of Stream Decker. Gosh, these things are all 4/3s. That's a start. Really, I can't just attack with all? I want to attack with all. Oh my gosh, I gotta do this. Yeah, no problem. Yeah, there wasn't an attack all because of like the war boss. They didn't let me. No, I understand how it usually works, but and it usually works with war boss, but for some reason this time it didn't. I probably need to. I mean, I guess I need to leave one creature back to block this Ravager Worm, but we're just dead. Came so close. Put them down to 3. They just didn't block one of the other creatures. We were one creature away.
I've seen things that would break someone like you.
We were one creature away. That's pretty close. For like how good our opponent curved out, we hit some really good Dark Dweller Oracle hits. I'm thinking I guess just these lava coils should be pretty good. I guess we have volley veterans too to kill things. Okay. Do I need more frenzies? I'm like wondering if I need more frenzies for like the card advantage, like when the board stalls, and like do we need more frenzies? Oh yeah, we are on a mold of five. That's right. Our opponent curved out that well, and we mold of five, and we almost got there. The problem with Frenzy is Vivian, but it's unclear how much they're going to be in on Vivian. Warchief is honestly good there. I don't know what my weakest card is. I don't know what I want to take out for these coils. I guess I'm going to trim a Warchief and an Oracle and two Bannerets. Siege Gang's really powerful, but it's also 5 mana. I don't want to, like, rely on, you know, having 5 lands all the time. You know, I'd like to have, like, the earlier starts. Yeah, you can check out the Grixis discard list. You can find it here on the Stream Decker page. StreamDecker.com/deck/ToddStevensMTG. If you want to watch the video of the deck, you can find it on the YouTube channel also. It worked out really well today. Played pretty well. Chain Whirler can attack through a Frenzy, or sorry, a Phoenix. Kill that. Good job, Volley Veteran, doing your thing. Alright, they're at 6. I mean, they can only block one thing. I don't really need to play this coil. I mean, I'm attacking for lethal. I just don't need to play the coil. So, yeah, I would usually coil first there. Banneret was pretty good. Kind of want another Banneret. That Hellkite card's gonna be a problem. But oh well. Maybe Firebrand's my worst card. Firebrand does take out Jade Light if I like set it up correctly. Let's play Banneret instead of Firebrand. Honestly, this, even if we lose this, I've been pretty impressed with our Goblin deck, though. It's played pretty well. No, I don't have the status Whirler combo here. Come on, deck. Say we have two draws to hopefully fill out the curve of getting something to do, but you know, on turn two. Being on the draw here. Okay, well, I guess that's something to do on turn two. I don't know if that counts or not. All right, I'm not going to play War Boss. I think they just have, like, instant speed removal. Let's get this Instigator going instead. I think they just have, like, Shock or Shiv and Fire. That kind of stuff. Especially how they miss the land drop. Yeah, and they were looking at their hand quite a bit. I like getting this Instigator here. Good, not a green source, so they can't Jade Light. Do they have Lightning Strike or something? Nah, Shiv and Fire. Yeah, that's what I thought. So good call on saving the War Boss. Would have just ate that Shiv and Fire real hard. All right. Well, that means no more Shiv and Fires. Didn't use it there. They're just keeping Druid? Oh, but they just want this thing to be a 4-3. I'll just Volley Veteran it. Our deck's pretty sweet. Of course, it helps the opponent stumbling and everything, but you can see the power of some of these cards. Volley Veteran's looking nice. It's just Ravenous Chupacabra. We're just playing Chupacabras over here. There you go. That's the link for donating right there. If you'd like to donate, right there. Find it. All right, play first. We do have a lot of one drops. I'm still gonna ship it. Like this a little more. Man, Trashmaster is a great card. And we only need one more land because like Warchief can reduce the cost, but we gotta do. Gotta be a little patient. I don't want to trade the Banneret. This one. land. Ugh. Ooh, wait, no, we need, that doesn't help. Let's play this thing. Yeah. So we can activate Banneret, make it a 4-2. It's really all about... If they have Trickster. Trickster is like the problem right now. I guess Trickster just eats the Banneret. The Warchief would still get the counter on it. Kind of bold. What are y'all thinking here? You know, I don't really want to throw like War Boss in front of the counter. They just have Trickster. They didn't like play Trickster at all last turn, and they could have like ate a Banneret. I guess their plan is just to chomp and try to race me. That's what their plan's looking like. How do I auto? I need to stack these things myself. Auto order. Okay, I need to stack them myself and make sure that the. So, at that case, I have to stack the 5-power one on first onto the stack, and then the 4-power one onto the stack. I need to make sure to do that so that the 4-power... So, like, you do the 5-power one first and then the 4-power one, because then the 4-power one will resolve, and it will turn the Trash Master into a 4-4, and then the 5-power one will resolve and turn the Trash Master into a 5-5. So I had to make sure to... to do that, but it worked out for us. So, all right, we got these lava coils and collisions coming on in. Kind of trimming some different spots. All right, let's try this. Yeah, we could have the 5 buff the 4 and then, you know, the other one buff that, but I guess that would be kind of the same thing of keeping it 5-5-4 either way. Yeah, just put the deck list in the donation message. That's perfect. You can also just send the deck list here, right here in chat, and I'll just save it, you know. Either way, I'll just be saving it. Let me know when. Oh gosh, this hand's probably a mulligan, right? let me know what day you want me to play it and what time slot. Like, do you want me to, so like, I usually stream from 3 to 10. Do you want it like around this time of night? So like, do you want me to play fourth on like a certain day, or like, you know, first, second, third, or fourth? You can also kind of tell me, you know, just around like what time-ish in the day. I can handle that too, of like, you know, around 4 o'clock or around 6 o'clock or whatever. This fits the curve, I suppose. It's not like the, yeah, I mean, it's fits our curve. Hey, Nick. Dang, they had another creature. I didn't want my opponent just to be able to Curious Obsession that Terramander and everything. I could sit back with the Firebrand there. But then if they have Curious Obsession and Dive Down, then it's like a, you know, a huge problem. So I thought just taking out their creature, hoping they didn't have another creature and a Curious Obsession, was a good option, and so that's what I went with. Because if I let them untap, they could have like the Dive Down to protect their Terramander, and Curious Obsession, you know, kind of thing. It's a worse play if our opponent does not have Dive Down. If they didn't have Dive Down, then doing it at sorcery speed, you know, doesn't make a whole lot of sense. Pretty good hand for the opponent, though. We'll see if we can win this race, but it's not super likely. It's not very likely. Making them stay back with Tempest Gin's good for us. Fortunately, it looks like our opponent has... Yeah, they have Trickster for how they were playing there. Certainly looked like a Trickster. I'm surprised they took all that. They just forgot to block. They had some kind of free blocks there. Can we draw something to play? Draw something to play. All right, we didn't do the whole draw something to play thing, but I'm attacking. Well, I'm sorry to say, opponent, this block is not very good. That was not a very good block. They're at 7. They left 4 2-2s unblocked with that double block. GG, Nick. Okay, so we are 4-1. We are moving on to the final boss. Goblins, final boss. This deck is pretty great, Sir Swindler. This deck is pretty great. Here we go. Get your final boss emotes out. Gotta get some luck. The 5-win dream is still alive. Yeah, Nick, that was a good game. Good match. What do you think of Calamity in this deck? Not worth a slot. I'd rather have other threats. You know, I'd rather just have the creatures. We're on the draw. I would not keep this on the play. On the draw, I'm still gonna mulligan. It's just so risky. Yeah, I have an elf deck. I haven't played it in a little bit, but yeah, I have a mono green elf deck. I guess I haven't played elves since RNA, actually. Now that I think about it, since Ravnica Allegiance, I haven't played elves. Because there were some good elves in Ravnica Allegiance. Tradesies? Opponent definitely has burn spell up. Wow. Or not? Or not burn spell up? I didn't want my war chief getting burned. Volley Veteran was the card I wanted to, like, I would have liked to be able to kill the Steamkin with Volley Veteran, but I suppose I could have just Trash Mastered, though, would have been good, but. They have Chain Whirler. Alright, no Chain Whirler. Come on, land. Land. This is where Steamkin takes over. We didn't get to kill that Steamkin fast enough. This is where it can take over with. Ooh, little surprised, to be honest, a little surprised they didn't just attack for four with the Steamkin and then activate. That's a great turn. Steamkin and Light of the Stage, match made in heaven. Hey, there we go. All right, cool. Yeah, that works. That'll work. Thank you so much, Joy. That looks to be... Alright, so we got some dinos. Is that just best of one? And I guess I need the mana base as well. Is that a sideboard? So I can do that one towards the end of the day tomorrow. So yeah, for the donation there, you have the cards that doesn't have the land, the mana base, or a sideboard if it's best 2 out of 3. Man, all 4 light up the stages. Okay. Yeah, you can. Yeah, you could also use like MTG Goldfish if you want. You can just paste the deck into MTG Goldfish if you'd like. That works really well. Here you go. Yeah, you can just paste it into here. Yeah, Goblin Gathering is way too slow. I was hoping that they would... hoping they were going to block with that Steamkin on the 4-2 and block the other one. I don't know. We are just really dead. Alright, Hawkeye, what are we doing? We're doing Daredevil and Coils. Could be a Frenzy Mirror. Let's... hard do I want to go with these Frenzies? Pretty hard. Yeah, I like Frenzies. So the thing is our opponent's going to be able to... Our one toughness stuff is... Our one toughness stuff is just not nearly as good against, like, Chain Whirler and stuff. No, I've never fed Hawkeye Fresh Trout. What am I saying? Okay, yeah, so our one toughness stuff's not so good against Chain Whirler. Usually this kind of matchup can be like when they have a whole lot of burn spells, it could be like us playing a bunch of cards, them using the burn spells, kill the cards. As long as we're able to kind of kill their creatures and keep the creatures at bay a little bit. The game can get pretty grindy, and so having Frenzies can actually be pretty good, because the game can go a lot longer than what you'd expect in a mono red mirror. I couldn't keep that Steamkin at bay. I needed that Volley Veteran to kill that Steamkin before it really went off, and unfortunately I could not kill it before. And just kind of looking back at that game in general, I bet there's places that I could have made some different decisions that would have been better for us. See, like, Frenzy would be looking really good right now. We'll be right back. right, thank you, Joy. There's the rest of the deck there, and the sideboard. Perfect. I have not tracked my win rate for when Hawkeye helps versus when he's somewhere else. Yeah, exclamation point decks, plural. Hawkeye's in the way for me. But that's where you can find that. So all we're doing is just exiling a card from the top of our library. I mean, that's a pretty good card. You know, we don't get to play this card at all, so, like, I didn't need to sacrifice, but with us... how we are drawing some of those lands there. Kind of felt it was worth it. This is a kind of spot here that I really wanted to block. Now they get to just add 3 mana. I kind of wanted just to block there. Okay, they didn't add the 3 mana anyway. Ooh, Chain Whirler is nice. That's a better one. So good exile. Chain Whirler is certainly better than... the War Chief would have been. Alright, let's get our music back. Our final boss playlist. Finished up there. You know, you want to keep playing your lands because when you have a card like Experimental Frenzy in your deck, which we have 4 Experimental Frenzies in here, when you have a card like Frenzy, you want to keep on playing. You know, don't keep lands in your hand. Play them out. Man, that's 3 Steamkins. For the opponent, we already Lava Coiled 1. Okay, there we go. That's certainly good. Our opponent's sitting at 3 mana and have, you know, had the Steamkins that have let them cast all these cards in their hand. We've had 6 land, so that's an extra 3 cards that our opponents had over us. Come on. I'm glad I brought in all 4 frenzies. We just didn't find them. Did a jump block last turn. Final boss is tough. Turns out Runaway Steamkin is kind of better than Little Tiny Goblins. That's what it turns out. 3 Steamkins for the opponent. Oh well, Goblins had a real good run there. Yeah, even though the 5-win dream died out there, unfortunately. Whoops, wrong emote. I meant that one. But yeah, this deck played pretty good. I liked it. I don't know about really too much to change. It felt pretty good how it was, honestly. Yeah. I think this one worked out pretty good. What do you think, Hawkeye? Worked good? All right, so I think that's it for me tonight. Wanted to remind y'all one more time. Horizon scares you? I haven't checked out any of the Horizons cards at all. I don't know. I didn't really feel like I wanted Skirk Prospector at all. And Siege Gang, maybe, like, honestly, maybe like one less land. We were flooding out a decent amount. Maybe like one less land for like another Frenzy or something, but got to make sure you get to your 4 mana. So that makes it a little tough to go under 23. But yeah, maybe we can afford it to go to 22 lands. That could certainly be a thing. So yeah, so that's going to be it for me tonight. But one last time, I wanted to remind y'all about Quip. You know, so looking for more people to sign up for Quip. Quip is an affordable, stylish electric toothbrush. It's a great electric toothbrush. If you go through my referral link, which I just put in the chat, you can find it down below in the info panel. Or if you're on YouTube, you can find this link down below in the information there. If you sign up for, use my referral code to sign up for Quip, not only do you get your first refill free, so you get an extra thing of toothpaste and an extra brush head sent to you after 3 months, you also get a free donation deck. So that's why we were playing Goblins here, because we had a viewer sign up for Quip and said, let's play some Goblins. So if you want you want a deck played on stream, that's an easy way to get that done. And yeah, one more reminder about tomorrow. Tomorrow's stream starting at 11 a.m. Eastern. So early start tomorrow. So 11 to 11 Eastern Standard Time. That's for a 12-hour stream tomorrow. Our next 12-hour streams are whenever we get to 10 people signing up for Quip or at 2,000 YouTube subscribers. So there we go. That's it for myself and for Goblins. There we go. Thanks for watching.